Statistics by the World Health Organization indicate that 77% of Ugandan girls miss school 2 to 3 days every month because of menstrual hygiene-related challenges. Among these challenges is lack of proper sanitary materials. The situation is not any different for older women. Statistics show that only 35% of the women are able to address their menstrual needs.
77% of Ugandan girls who go to school miss class 2 to 3 days a week, a month, because of menstrual hygiene-related issues, and one of them is lack of a sanitary pad. And the reason we are running this campaign, we want to create awareness about menstrual hygiene that is deemed as taboo in our society, but eating up a girl's child.
The Lions Club of Kampala has now launched a fundraising drive to help women and girls in Katanga Slum, Luengo and Iganga districts make their own sanitary materials. This way, many of them will be able to attain menstrual hygiene. The target of the project is over 1 million girls.
We are not giving a pad. We are going to train girls on how to make reusable sanitary pads. Why? Once I come and give you a pad today, your problems are sorted today. But I'm not giving you a lasting solution to it. But if I train you to make a pad, you're going to teach your sister, you're going to teach your mother. What started as a family is going to become a village, from a village to a parish, from a parish to a sub-county, and it will be a district and the whole country, Uganda.
Activity last year, but it mainly targeted women with disability. But now we're trying to go back to the same community, Katanga, where we were, and ensure that all women are included. It's funny to say targeting women and girls without those with disability is inclusive, but that's what we're trying to do for this time. And we would be happy with physically contacting 300 women.
Bernadette Ojao, the founder of Wabibi Pads Limited, revealed that they'll be training girls and women to make decent reusable sanitary pads. Men too will be involved to enable them address menstrual challenges for their teenage girls and wives.
Girls that messed up on a paper, an important paper, and that is the reason why I had to make sure that, you know, we created a solution to simple things that affect young girls, and yet they become a big deal. Yes, so our target for this campaign, of course, is millions of girls, not just one. I can't limit this. And we would like to teach them how to make their own pads, also give them education on menstrual health management.
This awareness campaign is not about women. It's bringing men on board. Many men do not participate in the menstrual life of their children. So sometimes it's not that they can't afford a sanitary pad, but they don't find it as a priority in a home. One can afford a beverage, but forego providing for a girl child. But if we bring them on board and they get to understand the magnitude of the issue, maybe we are going to have a steady progress.
The fundraising drive began with a movie night at the Century Cinema, whose proceeds were dedicated towards the cause. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.